Alright, good evening everybody. I'm going to try to show you how to fix a bug zapper. This one's a Stinger bug zapper. I'll look up the model number later and tell you exactly what it is. So I kind of cheated here. I've already taken apart and fixed it, so I put it back together kind of to show you how I took it apart and how I figured out how it came apart and then to fix it. So the first thing I did was I laid it down on the end here. Torx driver number 15, I believe it is. Torx T15. Which allowed me to take the base off. So I took that off and I set it aside. Then I could reach in here easily and pull the bulb out, which I did next. And then the hard part, so I can show you here. There's four screws. Four of these little Torx nuts that you've got to stick your hand way up in here and just take your time and screw all those fellas out. And then once you get those screwed out, I've got this taken off for now. Then I could get into the top of it. First time I took this apart, this was still attached. I had to reach all the way up in there and just take my time, take all those out, because I did not know how that came off. So once I got that off, I could see, and I'll try to show you. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 places where this kind of twists to lock on. But the problem is once it locks on, there's a little tab that pops up behind the attachment, so you can't just twist it back off because they lock into place. So there's a couple ways you can do it. One, if you're good enough, you can push down behind all five of these and twist it. But what I did, I just basically got a knife and cut all these tabs off except for one. That way when I put it back together, I can lock it in and I don't have to worry about it falling off. But it was easier for me to take apart. So then I had this off and I set it aside, which allowed me to get to the business part of the zapper. So then I simply just undid, it just pops off there. And then down at the bottom as well. Also, there's two red leads that come out, and one attaches to the outer cage and one attaches on the other side to the inner cage. I bought a new bug zapper because I've got a bunch of acreage and a bunch of bugs. So I noticed on the new one these are welded on, but on this older one I could simply take my needle nose pliers and push up and it popped right off. So, and then these just easily pop right out of these insulator holders. And again, I've already cut a couple wires to take this apart, but basically the first time when I took it apart, I moved this out of the way. These wires were down here, so the wires, first thing I did actually was I took this transformer out, got it out of the way. Once I got that, I could really see what was going on inside. And so I cut the wires going to the connector, that way I could take it all apart, because I knew I'd put that back together later. And then, which I still have this connector part of the way apart, see if we can zoom in so you can see here. Simple enough to get this connector out, because all you have to do is push out on that and it pops right out. So what I found when I got down to this connector was I had power coming to the connector. These two wires I cut so I could get to it, a red and a black. On one side of the connector. And then on the other side, these two holes, I had something that looked very similar to one of these. And what I found out is if you take one of these starters that you can get at a local hardware store, if you take it apart, this is the base that normally twists into a fluorescent starter base. And then inside of it was this RF compensator and the actual starter. Another option is I went down to, and thanks to Richards Lighting in Huntsville, Alabama, I went down there and asked them if they had a base for a starter, and they just went in the back and said, well, let's see what we've got, because they didn't have anything for sale. And so I have a simple base for my starter that I can just put in there. So when I put it back together, I can use this base with these two wires, and it'll be a lot easier. So that's basically what I did to get it apart. Thing that I did when I was trying to figure out what was going on, what the problem was, because I did not want to get shocked, is I took some electrical tape and simply taped up these little electrodes that hooked to the metal cage. Alright, so here's something I wanted to show you. This is where the bulb, this is the connector where the bulb plugs into. So you've got this connector, and the bulb is plugged in like this. So when you take this apart, the starter is on one side of the back of this. And then the lead wires are on the other side. So when you go to pull those out, it's like, okay, how do these come out? It doesn't want to pull out. So I took the cover off of this so you could see. And I'll try to show you. Here's a side view. I can zoom in here. Here's a side view. So when the wires go in, the little clip keeps it from pulling back out. So what I did to get it out, I just stuck a little tiny screwdriver down to the side of the cover and was able to be able to get that out. And I eventually ended up taking the whole cover off just so I could see what the interior looked like.